Shri Manohar Parikar, Honorable Raksha Mantri, Admiral Dhawan, former Chief of Naval Staff, former Commander-in-Chiefs, Principal Staff Officers, Mr. Harshvardhan Nautiya, President FICCI, Admiral C.S. Rao, Director General Naval Design, Submarine Design Group, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a matter of honor and a privilege to deliver the keynote address for this international seminar on the subject of high priority for the Indian Navy. At the outset, I would like to thank the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry for supporting the Indian Navy in organizing this seminar. This initiative clearly displays the intent of Indian industry to support our national vision of achieving self-sufficiency in designing and constructing underwater platforms. I remember Dr. ABJ Abdul Kalam asking this question in many of his talks. Do we not realize that self-respect comes with self-reliance, and self-reliance in defense production is therefore a vital prerequisite for us to be able to preserve and uphold our strategic autonomy. Towards this, the Indian Navy's roadmap for expansion and growth has continued to remain firmly anchored on indigenization for over 5 decades now. The Indian Navy has long identified this as the surety of sustainable and affordable defense. Coming to the field of underwater vehicles, the technology complexity of designing and building submarines is by far the highest for all military platforms. The Navy therefore took early steps in an attempt to develop its own design capability and formed a dedicated submarine design group within the ambit of the Directorate of Naval Design in 1986. It is with great pride that this year we are celebrating the 30th year of creation of the Navy's in-house submarine design capability. From its inception in 1986, with a small team of 16 officers, the submarine design group has grown into a robust and highly professional directorate with contemporary expertise and skill sets. The submarine design group has made significant strides in a wide range of capabilities related to design of underwater vehicles and in providing design support for construction in our shipyards. Our aim is to develop the capability to design underwater vehicles in future. The realization of this capability is essential if we are to truly meet our endeavor of Make in India in this niche field. I must, however, confess that the task cannot be accomplished by the Navy alone. Indigenization of military hardware can only fructify when with the collective might of the government agency, R&D agency, and industry in a focused and a forward-looking way to achieve this common goal. It also needs the firm support of robust budget and sound infrastructure. In order to make our intent clear, the Indian Navy has articulated an indigenization plan formally in various documents which have been shared regularly with all stakeholders for better synergy. The Navy's 15-year indigenization plan covers a period up to 2030. This has been augmented by a well thought out science and technology roadmap for 20 years from 2015 to 2035. Which identifies key technologies for indigenization. The national competence in submarine building is but an important subset of the overarching strategic objective of our country and our Navy, which has been articulated in the form of a 30-year submarine building program. While considerable success has been achieved in the field of indigenous warship design and building program, submarine design and construction is an area which continues to pose significant challenges. Design and constructing submarines is indeed an intensive process, both in terms of capital and technology. Our designers and manufacturers both need to clearly understand the requirement of the Navy. Similarly, we in the Navy need to appreciate the capabilities, capacities, limitations as well as the future potential of our industry. I am sure that the roadmap shared by the Navy with all concerned agencies will enable us to evolve an integrated approach for indigenization and innovation by our research laboratories and the industry. I have no doubt about the appetite of our industry has to venture into this evolving field. I must frankly express that I admire the courage it takes to invest in starting your own business, bear the pains of gestation, and work relentlessly to make your venture succeed. I am therefore sure that both the academia and the industry experts will see tremendous opportunities in these challenges. As the oldest apex body, FICCI has always played a very vital role in promoting new business opportunities. In the defense sector too, the contribution of FICCI in bringing about a positive industrial environment has been spectacular. We are therefore grateful to FICCI for enabling this interaction with all stakeholders present under the single roof. In order to encourage industry initiatives, the Navy on its part has made specific policy provisions. To stimulate untapped research potential, the Indian Navy cleanly promotes R&D activities in various academic institutions, including IITs and micro, small and medium enterprises through the Naval Research Board. The DPP 2016 has introduced a new category for capital acquisition under the Buy Indian category itself, called the IDDM, Indigenously Designed, Developed and Manufacture. This category has rightly been accorded the highest priority and is bound to give the required boost to indigenous industry in developing niche defense technology. Equipping our platforms with modern, reliable and proven system is essential. Towards this, I would like to highlight two aspects. Firstly, as we journey towards indigenization, it may be essential to partner with those who already possess the requisite domain knowledge and capacity. And second is to utilize this capability and knowledge to meet the envisaged timelines. You would agree with me that while there is a need for the industry to invest in more research and development, the temptation to reinvent the wheel can best be avoided. In an environment of global transparency, we can surely make use of meaningful partnerships with those who already have reached a certain level of maturity in submarine design and construction. In today's globalized world, while we seek to achieve a high percentage of self-reliance and indigenization, it is doubtful if any nation can achieve 100% self-sufficiency. The Make in India trust of our government is a timely opportunity for global partners to redefine their role and commitment towards Indian submarine building ventures and become credible stakeholders. The FDI in defense sector has progressively increased. This is a huge incentive to infuse modern technology into Indian industry. Indian companies, of course, stand to benefit from joint venture opportunities that open up. The new strategic partnership model, which is under finalization by the government, would take these initiatives in the right direction. The transfer of technology route has so far been the primary method of building partnership for development of new generation weapons, sensor and equipment for submarines. This approach will need a paradigm shift aimed at developing intrinsic technological capabilities by all agencies that can eventually lead to indigenous design and manufacture of submarine grade equipment. This will not be an easy task by any means. While R&D would have to leapfrog from absorbing current technologies towards developing future technologies, the industry will need to invest substantially in acquiring or developing expertise in the manufacturing sector. This will only enable realization of the high quality standards and technical specifications necessary for submarine and underwater platforms. Unlike the fast-moving consumer group segment, military assets have an inherent longevity. Our submarines typically have a lifespan of 25 to 30 years. The business model must therefore not only look at initial construction, but also life cycle support. This is an essential factor considered by any Navy to sustain itself as a fighting force in the long term. On the second aspect of delivery timelines, we must clearly state that given the rapid rate of obsolescence of technologies and systems, compression of project timelines is an important factor that needs to be considered by all stakeholders. This calls for perfect synergy between design organization, shipyard, R&D agencies, quality assurance organizations, defense PSU, private industry, to ensure that projects are progressed as per envisaged timelines and milestones. Achieving the ultimate goal of designing and building indigenous submarine platforms will require all these agencies to work in a cohesive manner with long-term perspective and commitment. If the Navy is to build an indigenous submarine fleet as planned, Indian yards will need investment, technology transfer, and considerable submarine building expertise to reduce production time and cost to match contemporary international standards. The success of this process will depend largely on our creativity, adaptability, and innovative thinking. I am hopeful that the theme of the seminar, Challenges in Design and Construction of Underwater Vehicles, will address these aspects in its two sessions on synergy between key players and the emerging submarine technology. I am sanguine that this seminar will provide an opportunity for the industry, academia and R&D agencies and represent their perspective. The deliberations will facilitate exchange of ideas, knowledge sharing and enable a clear understanding between all participants. A combined effort towards achieving national capacity and competence in submarine building requires each one of us to fully understand what is expected of us in the medium and long term. Based on our needs, we must evolve cohesive and well-integrated plans to build necessary skill sets in our individual areas and fully commit for the long haul. I am pleased to note that the seminar is well represented by all segments that are involved in submarine design, construction, equipment development and manufacturing. The deliberation in the course of the seminar will individually focus on most of these issues that I have mentioned and hopefully lead to deriving the way ahead. It is also important to keep this dialogue alive beyond the seminar hall so that all stakeholders evolve their strategy and plan for the implementation in a time-bound manner. As we dive deeper into the complex blue waters of the 21st century, we need to remain sharply focused and firm in our resolve to overcome the challenges in submarine design and construction, to self-reliance and synergy between all agencies. I will conclude by quoting our Honorable Prime Minister, who said, "In order to succeed, your desire to success should be greater than your fear of failure." Once again, I thank all the organizers and participants of this seminar in making this possible to be present here today, and I wish everyone fruitful and positive deliberations. Jai Hind.